Now, let's join Hunter Burns and Dixon Brook along the Black Warrior River in Alabama. A very effective tactic used by the Night and Hail team is the buddy system on working a gobbler. Dixon sets up 50 or 60 yards out ahead of the caller. Hunter, the designated caller, will use the terrain to stay out of sight of the approaching gobbler. This old gobbler responds to Hunter's hen calling and came into eyesight of Dixon, but refuses to enter effective shotgun range. After about 30 minutes of watching the hung-up gobbler, Hunter resorts to the effective last resort, the fighting purr calls. This fighting scenario is best created with a push-pull style call like the lonesome hen or the original fighting purr boxes. Having heard many turkey fights, Hunter uses his hat to create the sounds of flapping wings of actual turkeys fighting. Anytime you can add realism to your calls, it ensures in the turkey's mind he is actually coming to the real thing.
All of them are nice. You got some boots on them? Got some pretty good spur.
Oh, yeah, a little cloth thing. Oh, yeah, that's 3 year old turkey.
Yes, sir.
Oh, big beard. Big bird for Alabama.
Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you, man.
Good job. Good work.
Thank you. Great calling. He was wary, wasn't he?
That is a 22-pound, inch and a quarter Alabama turkey. You better take him when you can get him.
Yes, sir.
I agree.
Right.
Hunter, right. you lost your dad several years ago, and I know you was pretty close to him. He carried you everywhere you went, and since then, you kind of teamed up with this old boy here. Is this kind of your dad idol now?
It is. I tell you what, Dixon, he's a best friend to me, just like my dad was. He's helped fill in a void that's really, you know, I needed somebody. And Dixon's been a good buddy and good friend since, just like my dad was.
Well, that's about as special as it comes as far as I'm concerned. I appreciate hearing that.
Well, you know, that is a special deal. Now, Dixon, tell me something. EBSCO bought us out, or really Pradco did, bought out Night and Hail a few years ago, and y'all are the parent company of Pradco, and what is your title there?
Well, I'm a member of the board of directors, and I run the library service division called EBSCO Subscription Services.
And you are in the family, married in the family?
Right.
So that's good. And I tell you what, it don't hurt nothing to get out here with the old boss man and show him how to kill a turkey every once in a while. Maybe he showed us how to kill one.
I tell you what, he's about as good a shot as you want to see, I tell you. Very seldom does he not put one down.
Well, you know, probably if I was going to give a tip for the day on this particular hunt here, there is no doubt that patience, and when everything else, we've always said on the fighting end of it, when nothing else works as a last resort, and this was a 30-minute hunt, it was time for the last resort, and I didn't want to spook your turkey, but I figured he was going to see that hen or he wasn't coming. And when you went to beating on your legs back there and doing the fighting purr, he couldn't take him. And you was doing that little lonesome hen too, wasn't you?
I was doing that little lonesome hen, doing a little purring on it, and also with those end up to get a little more aggressive. I got the fighting purrs out, and then I got a little more tuned to it. And,
whatever you did brought him on.
That woke him up because he had already stood out there as long as he could stand it, and he had gone back undercover, and he did gobble back undercover, but when the fighting purrs came on,
he couldn't take it, could he?
He couldn't take it. He stepped out in the open and then started coming.
That's what an old turkey does when he hangs up. He'll do that a lot of times. Well, Dixon, you got a good one. What do you say we go back and show this to somebody, because I know you wait to show it to somebody.
I guarantee you I am.
You can drag the feathers off of him, aren't you?
That's great. It's a great feeling. Thank you.
Good job.